Hello everybody, welcome back to Screen Stars, and welcome to my next series of classic film reviews. I've done Rutger Hauer, I've done Denzel Washington, they're all on the channel, as well as the top 10 list of my favourite films. And I thought for this one I would put a little poll up on Twitter. And the Twitter was for you guys to choose who you would like me to focus my next classic film reviews on, and top 10 list. And Mel Gibson was the winner. So, one of my favourite actors, I know he's had his ups and downs, I think it's fair to say, certainly this last decade or so. And he was the least popular person on the planet at one time, it would seem. But he's still a great actor and has made some very, very iconic films over the years. So the first film that I have chosen to do my classic film review on for Mel Gibson is the 2002 film directed by Randall Wallace, We Were Soldiers, the superb war film that stars obviously Mel Gibson. We have Madeleine Stowe, we have Greg Kinnear, we have the great Sam Elliott, we have Chris Klein, Kerry Russell, Barry Pepper, and there's a whole host of faces you'll recognise in this film. And this tells the true story of the first real conflict of the Vietnam War. And Mel Gibson plays Lieutenant Colonel Hal Moore, who leads this set of relatively green troops into Vietnam for the first time, into the first major battle. It's into an unknown, really, and his unit and his men get outnumbered, get outflanked, outthought sometimes, and he's got to try and outthink his enemy and keep his men alive the best as he can, and try and win this battle in what would seem to be increasingly terrible odds for him and his men. Now then, if you've never seen We Were Soldiers, I think you're in for a bit of a treat here. This is, for me, I'll be honest, I'm not really a huge fan of war films, generally speaking. They don't often do a lot for me, and because usually the Hollywood eye sometimes, and they're made out to be these superhuman superheroes, and I like war films that have a more realistic edge to them, and they don't portray, you know, like the American soldiers, for example, as like these superheroes. So when they're done like this film is done, I like them. We Were Soldiers, and that's what I like about this film. It does it from a lot of different perspectives. You get obviously the perspective of Mel Gibson and his men on the ground. You get the perspective of Madeleine Stowe, who plays his wife in the film, and the other wives back home, what they have to deal with when they start getting notified of their husbands dying. But you also get a perspective from the Vietnam side, from the officers on that side, and so it's not an unbalanced film in that sense. You do get a few different perspectives here, and I really appreciated that at the time. And it's kind of told through the eyes of Joe Galloway, played by Barry Pepper, and it's actually based on his book, who joined this group of soldiers as a reporter, and he went away afterwards and wrote a book, a very emotional book apparently, which was called We Were Soldiers Once and Young. He's kind of told through his eyes, not the whole thing, because the first part of the film, it is focusing on Mel Gibson training his men, choosing his officers, choosing Greg Kinnear's helicopter units, because they decided to try this new approach to battle, a new version of like a cavalry, if you like. So the helicopters are the horses, and they, you know, they would carry the troops into Vietnam, drop them off, take off, go back, get more troops. So it was like a constant convoy of helicopters, dropping off men and supplies and taking back the wounded. And it had never been done in battle before, so it was the first time it had ever been attempted. And everything I've just said there make this film really, really interesting to watch. But it nails the action side of it as well, and the war scenes, the fairly brutal, pretty in your face, quite upsetting. There's some scenes of characters dying that is really quite deeply upsetting because she got quite attached to them, and their immediate families and things like that. And it is actually hard to watch sometimes. There's a great scene in this film where it's, you know, the first night, there's like a unit of soldiers run off chasing these Vietnamese soldiers foolishly, and they get pinned down in this, you know, in like the jungle, and they can't go back, they can't go forward, they're just pinned down, and there's not many of them left, not much ammo. There's a great scene, one of the best in this and any war film, where you can hear them talking, saying, I can smell them, I know that they're out there. So they radio in for some like illumination in the sky, and as soon as that illumination lights up the sky, you can see like these Vietnamese soldiers literally this close to them, pretty much, and it's terrifying. It's fantastically well done. So the action scenes, the war scenes, the shooting scenes, they're all done really, really well, but quite respectfully too. It reminded me a lot of way of Hacksaw Ridge, the Mel Gibson directed film that came out a year or two ago, which was outstanding too. It was that kind of approach to war, didn't really hold back, and Mel Gibson, he's bloody outstanding in this film. And you do forget sometimes how good an actor Mel Gibson is. He really gives a powerhouse performance here, very emotional at times, and there's a great line at the end where he says, I'll never forgive myself, and Barry Pepper's Joe Gallery asks him why. He says that my men died and I didn't. I mean, and when you hear that and you see it, when he's crying when he says it, you just choke up. So it's a really fantastic film. It's an 8.5 out of 10, almost a 9 for me. It's a really brilliantly made war movie, and definitely one of my favourite Mel Gibson films. So thank you for watching, everybody. This is my first classic Mel Gibson film review. Pop it in the comments if you want to have a guess at what the next two are going to be before I do my top 10 list. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time on Screen Stars.